Good afternoon, everyone. This is Symantec School of Intelligence Network. My goal for the company is to take all the security intelligence data that we collect from all our sensors across the world and try in some small way to make sense of it so that we can sort of be able to talk intelligently with not only our customers, but obviously the general public at large about what the threat landscape looks like. What is the problem? Primarily, how big is the problem? Should we be concerned? I'm going to leave off today by sort of giving you an update about what we see the threat landscape looking like today. And what I can tell you is the threat landscape today presents nothing of the threat landscape 20 years ago, nothing of the threat landscape 5 years ago, and probably not much like the threat landscape 2 years ago. We have gone from, the very first worms and the threats that we saw designed to steal medical information, copy software, to network-aware worms that travel to the globe, to attacks that target industrial control systems and put pressure on industrial SCADA systems and critical infrastructure. Last year alone, we saw 3.8 million new threats. 2004, we saw 460,000. Think about that. 3.8 million new threats. The world has changed. This is not my older brother's opinion. We see new actors. The vast majority of today's threat activity and most of the threats that we see today are actually driven by cyber crime. Not even 95% of all the malware that we see is around cyber crime in one form or another, whether it's a keystroke logger or whether it's a backdoor designed to exfiltrate information. But what about that other 10-5%? Stuff that we don't even hear a lot about, but we're starting to know. These are the targeted attacks. The attacks are targeting enterprises. The attacks that are targeting nuclear facilities, the attacks that are targeting government departments, which ones do we should be concerned about? I would argue, obviously, both. But the ones that we're talking about government, there's a delineation between the types of attackers. We've all heard the stories of Eastern European gangs who got together, they make auction sites, produce credit cards, and bring people along. Those stories are absolutely true, and that's the vast majority. What about the attackers we don't know? The ones that are designed to address the assessment of the life of critical infrastructure. What about them? What about the nation's critical infrastructure? We have a class of attackers that are much more difficult to root out, much more dangerous than usual script agencies that we're sometimes referred to. Make no mistake, today's threat landscape is extremely complicated. Attackers are extremely sophisticated. The prime which is the most part is money. But we're seeing the rise again of nationalism in terms of cybersecurity and hackers. You only have to look at the situation around WikiLeaks and the group Anonymous, who launched a distributed amount of service attacks around some of the funding for WikiLeaks was pulled. We have an event that's transpired in the past couple days around HP Garrett. Company that has fallen foul of Anonymous, where very companies with livelihoods has now been threatened. Millions and millions of dollars of business, all due to hackers. Perceived threat or slight of a group of anonymous individuals around the world. Economies are closely tied together. Infrastructure spans countries and the globe. Someone's problem in the UK may not be our problem here today, but it's likely to be our problem tomorrow. We know of targeted attacks directed towards NASDAQ in recent past. That's what we find. Vulnerabilities have become institutionalized and part of our day-to-day business. We have to deal with vulnerabilities in hardware and software, and vulnerabilities in people. Never forget, it says a lot. The world's second oldest profession is social engineering. phishing, fraud, levels we've never seen before. Spam levels are running at around 80 to 90% of all email is spam. And attacks. Attacks are so large that it's difficult for even nation states to stop them. So, with all